best at making Chinese executives happy while demanding millions as a payout. I'm not kidding. The 2017 message reading, quote, 10 million per annual budget to annum budget to you. There's some spelling. There's some spelling typos in this. Not in us, but in his WhatsApp message. To use to further the interests of the joint venture, the Bidens are the best to know at doing exactly what the chairman wants from this partnership. Is this unbelievable? Here with more is Shapley's attorney and in power oversight president, Tristan Levitt. Tristan, you represent Gary Shapley, one of the whistleblowers that have come forward. And these WhatsApp messages are part of the area in which the IRS couldn't go. They were told, you're not going to go into these international business dealings, right?
Well, to some extent, they looked a lot at the international business dealings, but those messages deal with, obviously these specific deals with the Chinese companies. And these are part of the same messages where Hunter Biden said, I'm sitting here next to my dad, and the investigators ask about the dad. Can't ask about the big guy. They're blocked from subpoenas or search warrants at the Biden residence in Delaware. So those are the further angles that were all blocked off by prosecutors in Delaware.
Why?
That's a good question. Gary doesn't pretend to know the answer. Some of it, you know, again, after a few months of that, it was clear to him that this is being treated differently. He tried to write that off. He tried to say, well, look, people have differences of opinion all the time. But after two full years, and especially, you know, culminating in this red line meeting he's talked about, he said, I don't know what their motivations are, but it's clear that this has been, you know, this is wrong and people need to know about it.
And when he came out and was obviously a dissenter and a whistleblower, has he been punished? Has it been retribution?
Yeah, he's been treated very differently. So we submitted, you know, we haven't focused a lot on that because the key thing is the information that he's brought forward. But, you know, there have been definite repercussions at his agency, which continue to this day. And so we're hopeful to see remedial action there. But Gary's point all along has been, this isn't about me. This is about the information
right there.
And of course, Attorney General Merrick Garland has tried to make it about, you know, Gary Shapley versus the Attorney General.
So David Weiss, in a letter back to Jim Jordan, said, you know, I am the decision maker. But according to Gary Shapley and other whistleblowers, he wasn't the decision maker. And he said almost as much in front of how many people?
Well, there were six witnesses there. So two from the FBI, two from the IRS, and then two from the U.S. Attorney's Office for Delaware. And we've, you know, again, that information was documented contemporaneously by Gary. His supervisor agreed in email. And so that's been what the focus has been for the past few days. But now that the New York Times says that they've independently confirmed that California also, refused to bring charges, this takes it away from Gary. It's clear now. Others are figuring out that what Gary's brought forward is the beginning of a further investigation, but it's about Weiss versus Garland and the substance that's there because Weiss was clearly blocked.
So let's get this straight. One of the allegations by Gary Shapley is that Weiss wanted to bring this to D.C., and Matt Graves said, no, you're not going to bring it here because the violations happened in D.C. They said, I want to bring it to Los Angeles, and they said, you can't bring it here. Merrick Garland calls a press conference and says, I don't know what you're talking about. I told him he has free reign to do what he wants. I don't know who would stop him. Well, the New York Times found out last night that the L.A. story is true. He was stopped from bringing those charges. Do you believe that Merrick Garland was behind stopping him in both those areas? Do you think that's new news to him?
I think it's new information. I don't think he was behind that. I think you just have two other, you know, Senate, you know, U.S. attorneys who were nominated by the president, who are confirmed by the Senate, and they have their own authority to do what they like. And U.S. Attorney David Weiss doesn't have the authority to bring charges in their district without their permission. So whether Garland was in the dark or whether he is just playing, you know, word games with some sort of nuance saying, well, he didn't come to me personally, he didn't do this or that, I don't know. But clearly, he's wrong on some of these facts.
So I want you to say that the witnesses that have come forward have been confirmed that were in the room. Baltimore FBI agent, Special Agent Tom Sobczynski, Assistant Special Agent in Charge Rashia Holly, Special Agent in Charge Daryl Walden, IRS Special Agent in Charge Gary Shapley, obviously. So these guys are sitting there, and they hear David Weiss say, I'm not the ultimate authority on this. He's Trump-appointed. Everyone keeps saying Trump-appointed. Why won't David Weiss stick up for himself and says, I'm being stopped here?
That's the question of the year, Brian. I don't know, but ultimately he has to answer these questions about why he told one group of individuals one thing and then told Congress a different thing. Again, I don't know if it's technicalities. His letter to Jim Jordan said, I have the authority consistent with department regulations and, you know, prosecutorial standards. And so if he's hiding behind those words to, you know, if that's where the fact lies, that under department regulations, he didn't have the authority, they're playing word games and it's too cute by half.
So, Tristan, what has Congress told you is the next step? Obviously, you'll testify. Your client is doing an interview with Brett tonight. It's going to be great. He's talked to other people. What is next? To get Gary in front of oversight and to get David Weiss there?
Yes, the key thing, I mean, obviously our client will testify where he needs to, but the key thing is that this can't rely on his shoulders. He doesn't know what the interactions were between Weiss and Main Justice. Weiss needs to come and explain this. So if it gets down to the middle of July and Gary's still the only one bringing this forward, that will be a really significant disservice to these whistleblowers. They've given the important starting information. Now it's up to Congress to interview the other witnesses and advance the investigation.
You think it's important for the country to know if the Biden family was involved in Hunter Biden's dealings?
In terms of the knowledge that Gary has, he's brought forward these representative examples. And that information that I'm privy to, right, is limited to what the investigators had. But they weren't able to follow up on the leads on the laptop. They don't even know that they got all of the full information from the laptop because prosecutors blocked them from getting it, even though they had independently confirmed that it was Hunter Biden's.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comments section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the McCad TV family. Please like and share McCad TV. We love you all. Please support McCad TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.